नारी स्तन भरनाभिदेशम् दृष्ट्वा मागामोहावेशम् एतन्मांसवसादिविकारम् मनसि विचिन्तय वारं वारम् भज गोविन्दम् भज गोविन्दम् गोविन्दम् भज मूढमते।
नौ कम्स अ वेरी कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल टॉपिक एंड दैट इज द टॉपिक ऑफ सेक्स। नाउ अवर स्क्रिप्चर्स आर वेरी क्लियर विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू ऑल टॉपिक्स। Without any feeling of shyness, they openly tell the things as it is. Now, this is a very controversial topic and it is a very, what you call, disturbing topic for many of us. And the victims are the modern generation, the present youngsters. When they become teenagers, they are disturbed by lust. The parents don't know how to guide them. The teachers also, they keep quiet. And ultimately, the youngsters, they read some cheap magazines. They visit the internet sites. Right? The media is also equally misguiding them. Poor youngsters of the modern age, we really pity for them. No guidance they receive. And they are not able to share their problems with anyone. But we have the scriptures which give a perfect guidance. Unfortunately, scriptures are banned in the colleges. So therefore, they don't get this knowledge from anywhere. And there are hundreds and thousands of people who misguide them also, including the media. You find today's TV, everything is misguided information only. So naturally, this present modern generation, they find it very difficult. Especially recently, I went to college. So there, most of the questions which the youngsters asked were related to this topic. Because they were not getting correct guidance. The scriptures are very clear. What is the goal of human life? The whole goal of human life is only one thing: happiness, joy, fulfillment, etc. Now, how much happiness do we want? We want happiness which is infinite, and we want happiness for infinite period of time. Yes, complete fulfillment is what we look forth in life. Now, the question is, sexual pleasure, can it satisfy this condition or not? So, what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to analyze this experience. So when we analyze, we find there are six defects in sexual pleasure. Defect number one, the happiness which we get, of course there is pleasure, there is happiness, no one can deny it. But the pleasure is momentary, time-wise there is limitation, that is defect number one. Defect number two, not only there is time-wise limitation, there is also intensity-wise limitation. You can't get infinite happiness out of it. It is also a finite happiness. That is defect number two. Defect number three, every sexual pleasure will lead to the vitality of the body being drained away. Sarvendriyanam jarayanti tejaha. This is the answer which Nachiketa gives to Yamaraj. When Nachiketa was asking for this, knowledge for the highest truth, Yamaraj, Lord Death, starts tempting him, saying that I will give you apsaras. Don't ask this knowledge. I will give you wealth, gold, land, long life, whatever you ask, I will give you. But don't ask about this highest truth. So when Yamaraj was tempting Nachiketa, Nachiketa said, sir, you keep your dance and music with you. Tavaiva vaha tavan nritya geete. Your nrityam and geetam, you keep it with you. You give me that ultimate truth. And about this, all these apsaras and all. Sarvendriyanam jarayanti tejaha. It drains away the vitalities of the body. A person who is continuously sexually involved, his health, his peace of mind, everything will go away. So that is the third defect. Physical health is ruined. Fourth defect. Any amount of satisfying the desire will not put an end to desire. Desire will only multiply. Dushpurena analena cha. Bhagavad Gita says it. Just like fire, they say. Dushpurena. Meaning, it cannot be satisfied. A fire, you keep on putting fuel into it. Will the fire ever say enough? Never. It will keep on burning. In the same way, the sexual pleasure cannot be satisfied by fulfilling the desire. Each time you fulfill the desire, the craving starts increasing more and more, more and more, just like fire. So that is the fourth defect. Desires cannot be completely fulfilled. The fifth defect is, a person who is continuously engaged in such ignoble act, slowly, slowly he becomes a slave of his mind. His mind starts becoming so powerful. Such a person will have no control over his own mind. That is defect number 5. Defect number 6. The moment lusty thoughts fill our hearts, you will find your intellect is getting veiled. Your ability to think, you will lose. It will cripple your intellect. That is why the great famous people, they fall into this trap. Actually, we should not blame them. What happens is, when this desire comes, your intellect is cut off from you. From then onwards, though you may be a highly educated man, you may know the consequences, but since your intellect is cut off from you, such a person who is not able to access his intellect for right guidance, such a person behaves like an animal. Because the difference between an animal and a human is only that a human being has got the intellect, animal doesn't have it. Now what happens when lusty thoughts fill our hearts is, this intellect gets veiled. Jnanam avritya dehinam, it is said. You may be a knowledgeable person, but that knowledge will not be available to you. There is a beautiful question which Arjuna asks. Atha kena prayuktoyam papam charati purushah anichchannapi varshnaya baladivaniyojitah. A beautiful question is asked by Arjuna. The question says, Bhagwan, tell me, why is it that people commit sin even though they know that it is a sin? As though helplessly they go and commit this sin. Why do they commit that sin? This question is asked. At that time, Bhagwan says, Kama esha krodha esha rajoguna samudbhavah mahashanah mahapapma vidhyena miha vairanam. Arjuna, know them to be your greatest enemies. Who are they? Kama and krodha, anger and lust. Mahapapma, it is a mahapapi. Beware. Is the greatest enemy. In another place also this kama is mentioned. Trividam narakasyedam dwaram nashanamatmanah kamakrodhas tatha lobhah tasmat etatrayam tyajet. There are three doorways to hell. Because majority go there, so one doorway is not enough. Three doorways are there. One is kama, lust. Another is krodha, anger. The third one is lobha, greed. Bhagwan says these are the three doorways to hell. Therefore, give up these three. So what are the defects we have seen? Number one, happiness out of sex, it is limited. Number two, time-wise limitation is also there. Number three, desires are never satisfied. Number four, the health is ruined. Number five, we become a slave of our mind. Number six, intellect is crippled the moment lusty thought comes. Now tell me, is it worth to entertain such lusty thoughts? Our scriptures are very clear. They are not afraid of answering any questions. Any problems of life, they are ready to solve it with logical answers. Now the major problem which every one of us faces is, we intellectually understand this, but in order to practice it, it becomes very difficult. It becomes very difficult because sexual pleasure is one pleasure where almost all the senses are involved. This is one great tragedy Whereas every other pleasure, only one or two senses are involved. Whereas in this pleasure, all the senses are involved. So therefore, it is very difficult to control the mind. Now the question is, can we suppress these desires? The answer is, never do that. Because suppression is never a solution. You may suppress your desire, but it will be like a pressure cooker. How long? It will explode. That is why the modern psychologist says, don't suppress sex. But then what should we do? That they don't say. They say indulge better. Now scriptures are again very clear about it. They say yes, we are not for suppression, we are for sublimation. This is the solution which the scriptures give. Now what do you mean by sublimation? Sublimation involves two aspects. Number one, thoroughly understand the defects of sexual pleasure, as we had seen now with these six defects. First of all, intellectually have a clear understanding of these defects. But this is only a half part of the story. The second part is Bhaja Govindam. Meaning what? See, mind wants happiness. So wherever there is a possibility of gaining happiness, the mind will go there. In Bhagavad Gita itself, Bhagavan says, Indriyasya indriyasyarthe ragadvesho vyavasthitau. However great a person may be, the senses will have attraction for the sense objects. It is by nature, by default. So naturally the mind will be attracted towards such sense pleasures. But remember, why does the mind go there? Mind goes there because it needs happiness. Now suppose there is a possibility that you give a greater happiness, a more nobler happiness to the mind, so you will find the mind leaving this ignoble pleasure and going towards that. Suppose you expose your mind with the joys of devotion, the joys of the peace and cheerful way of living, healthy way of living, exposed to the joys of higher meditation. Once the mind tastes this higher joys of devotion and meditation, you will find your mind having lesser and lesser interest in all these vulgar pleasures. This is the best way, and it is called sublimation. This is what the scriptures advise us to do. Number one, you must know the defects of sense pleasures. Number two, you must also know the higher joys which are possible after having been born as human beings. Once this much knowledge is given to the mind, you will find the mind easily dropping the lower and going on towards the higher. This is the path mentioned by the scriptures. This knowledge has to be given to the youngsters. As long as this knowledge is not given, they will be stuck up. How much ever you try to control your youngster, your son, your daughter or whatever, prohibiting from, you know, watching all these ignoble websites and all, it is not going to work. Because the mind needs happiness, it will crave for all those happiness. As long as the guidance is not given, they will not listen to your advice. Recently I went to one school and I was just addressing some parents. Many of the parents and teachers had this complaint. The school children are going to some websites and all and browsing all those, what you call, dirty websites. Then I asked them, what are you trying to do? They just try to prohibit. But that won't work. As long as you keep the scriptural knowledge away from your life, remember, peace of mind is not for you. Forget about peace. Forget about guiding the younger generation. It is impossible. So, scriptural knowledge is absolutely essential. Now remember, devotion for God is absolutely essential with respect to this trap. In Bhagavad Gita itself, Bhagavan says, Devi Hesha Gunamai Mama Maya Duratyaya. Bhagavan himself says, my Maya is so powerful, no one can overcome it. Duratyaya means impossible. Attraction towards opposite sex, it is impossible to win over, except on one condition. What is that? Mameva ye prapadyante maya metam tarantite. Yes, there is one, only one. There is only one way of overcoming this attraction. What is that? Surrendering unto the Lord. Oh Lord, I am no one. Please protect me. When you completely surrender, you will find that in the very instant, all these ignoble thoughts will vanish from your mind. Now here, Bhagavan Shankaracharya gives a technique of winning over. What does Bhagavan says?
Nari stana bhara nabhi desham drishtva maga moha vesham.
Oh my dear man, by looking at these fleshy parts of woman, don't get infatuated. Now the instruction is given to man. You know why? Because he is the monster. All problems are created by man only. You read the newspaper. So the instruction is given to man and not a woman. But that doesn't mean that, you know, women, they don't have any such feelings. No. Opposite attraction, sexual attraction towards the opposite sex, it is natural. But what Bhagavan is trying to say is, the moment you expose yourself to a sense object, naturally you will find the mind entertaining ignoble lusty thoughts. That is what is represented by this Vali and Sugriva fight. The moment Sugriva comes in front of Vali, what happens? The 50% strength of Sugriva goes to Vali. Now this Vali is sense object, remember. And Sugriva is our case. We are the Sugrivas. So how can Sugriva win over Vali? Impossible without the help of the Lord. So Rama Bana has to come. That alone can kill Vali. Meaning surrender unto the Lord. Never expose yourself to sense objects. You can never win. It is impossible. Drishtva maga moha vesham. Don't get infatuated. So at that time, suppose helplessly you are exposed to such a thing, what kind of thoughts must spontaneously arise in your mind? Bhagavan says, etan mamsa vasa adi vikaram. Immediately understand what is the content of that body. The packing may be beautiful, but the contents are filthy. Fat, urine, excreta, whatnot, all nonsense, all dirty things are filled inside. Bring in this thought process. Don't think that it is a wonderful thing, I will get happiness. No, then you are finished. Immediately try to bring in the opposite thought current. It is called pratipaksha bhavana. See the other side of the coin. But that also may fail, remember. Because as long as your intellect is with you, you can entertain such thoughts. But what does this lust do? It covers the very intellect itself. Now once the intellect is covered, you are finished. So even this entertaining thought also will not work. So what is the only remedy then? Bhaja Govindam. That is the only remedy. The ultimate remedy.